Cody with Mainstream. I'm about ready to swap out a motherboard in a Q600. This guy's been giving us a fit here lately, so we're down to trying the motherboard. Now I've removed the front cover and I've undone the face. The next thing I need to do is I need to slowly pull out this face here. In fact, I might have to pop this cover. To get to the other side of here, because I believe, yeah, it wants to, there we go, there's a little sleeve that has to be pulled up, so it helps if you got some fingernail, and that relieves that banner there. We're going to need that. Here's the new board Gary sent. Thank you very much, Gary. He's a huge help. Not met Gary, he's a wealth of information, super cool guy. And we will go ahead and remove each of these sides. And as you can tell, it's pretty self-explanatory. So now that I say that out loud and I hear myself, it makes sense at this point to go ahead and just pop that out and just go one for one and let it support itself. So one off, one on. I believe this is how I did it at Mike's too. I just looked at it and thought, man, this is lays out simple. Of course, I'm doing this gentle. I removed the preheater earlier on this. Sometimes you might see that little tab there. That's what you really gotta relieve to get these out. Let's do the pinky trick. All right. It's interesting. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, this one's got a little added something that I'm not used to seeing on this other board. No worries. Okay, now I'll just relieve this side, and then this board just pops right out. It's got these little clips that are just stabilizing it, so it's pretty easy to just swap out. See those little grooves there, and little teeth here. I'll grab the side of the board and I'll just pop it up gently. Grab the side of the board, pop it up gently, slide it forward. It's just going to lift right out, except I've got these bottom connections, the power. You know what? Let me just... Yeah, as I freak everybody out, I am totally off power. I checked that before I did this, but you know, it's always good to double check. Because I didn't bring it up earlier. And I am always up early. Because I think some of the best learning a person can do happens in the morning. So here we are. Go ahead and set this new board in place. Same thing here, I'm just going to pull back a little bit. It just seems to give the board some stress relief. All these connections are tidied up. These ones go right back where they were. Preheater goes there. That banner, okay, so we gotta make sure that this sleeve is up. You see how it just lifted up there gently, so pull that sleeve out. And at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and secure this door back on. Make sure all your wiring's tidy and seated properly. So we'll just gently push that into those doors. There we go. And then I'm gonna support it in the back again. And just gently get that banner's contacts in there. Might have to pull the collar up a few times to get those contacts in to sit in there, and then push that collar on down. Yep. That just seated nicely for me there. Now, you'll know if this is not correct because your face won't work. Got a little wiring problem there, Coot. Well, we're working with EPP, so it's a little forgiving. Put those wires inside there. Looking good. Looking good. I thought it felt like some piece of wire that was in the way. You know, it's really... It fits one way, and it'll tell you if it doesn't agree with the positioning that you're on.